Hello students, we are continuing with the concept of the midpoint line drawing algorithm, and as you have seen in the all previous parts that we are coming out step by step with the derivation of how to write the algorithm or how to come out with the steps to write the algorithm by using the decision variable t. And now the previous thing that you have, if you remember, is the d, initial d that we have to calculate. When I start from the point x naught and y naught will be a plus b by 2. And what is this a plus b by 2? So it is actually the new decision variable, or the d start is the new decision variable that I will have to start with. And also you can see that everywhere I have some fractions are like this. So to avoid these fractions, I can say that I will multiply it throughout by 2, that is the whole the function, that is f of x y function, that is ax plus by plus c. So the whole thing I will multiply it by 2, and everywhere, even here I will multiply it by 2. So then what happens, it becomes 2a plus b, and it becomes a 2 into ax plus by plus c. So by this we will be avoiding the fractions. So the d start now will be 2a plus b, and we always know that a is dy and b is minus dx, and therefore d start will be 2dy minus dx. So this is the d start. So d start is what we know now, and the change in ne we know, and the change in e we know. So using all this, we'll have to write an algorithm now. So I will write the algorithm in detail, and using this algorithm you can write the program whichever programming language you feel comfortable with. So the algorithm is free from any syntax of a particular programming language. The line is started with x naught y naught, and the line is ending at x1 y1, and this is the initial points that we will consider. And the function is MP, midpoint line drawing algorithm, so we'll give the name as MP. So it is int x naught y naught int x1 y1 is the function function with the parameters that I'm taking. And if your decision variables and if your dx and dy are all to be declared here, so the dx happens to be x1 minus x0, and dy happens to be y1 minus y0, and the new decision variable, that is the d start, what we had already derived. If you remember, in the previous parts we have already derived all these things. So using all these mathematical derivations, now just we are putting it into the algorithm form, that's all. So this d is equal to 2 into dy minus dx, and the change in e, that is delta e, is 2dy, and the change in ne is equal to 2dy minus dx. And then I'm starting the line with the x is started with x naught and y is started with y naught. Okay, so this is the derivations values that we have seen in the previous thing, so that we have now declared it and we have assigned it with the particular values. And now we'll see how do you write the iterations part, that is your x is incremented from x naught to x1, and then here you can see the decision variables, how it gets affected. So if your d is less than or equal to 0, we have said that if it is less than or equal to 0, we are selecting the pixel E. If it is greater than 0, we are selecting the pixel NE. If it is 0, so you can select either of this. So therefore, if it is less than or equal to 0, that is, if the decision variable is less than or equal to 0, in both the cases, I am selecting what pixel is E pixel. And if I select the pixel E, then the decision variable should get affected according to the increment E value. And what is the increment E value that we have assigned is 2dy, and that we have got it in the derivations again. And next is x is incremented by 1 here. So the if I select the pixel E, x is incremented and not y, therefore only x is incremented here. In the next part you can see else your decision variable changes according to your increment NE, because I am choosing the pixel NE. And in this case, if you remember, so x is incremented as well as y. So because NE pixel is the one that I select, so NE pixel is moving upwards. In that case, both x gets incremented and y also gets incremented. Therefore, the change in NE happens to be like d is equal to d plus increment NE, and I increment both x as well as y. And then if I choose either of this, so if I choose E or if I choose NE, accordingly my decision variable is calculated. So when the decision variable is calculated and my y and x values are known, using that I draw a pixel. And whenever I draw a pixel, so whenever I draw a pixel, so x and y values are used. And how are x and y values used? So x and y values are incremented here in this case if I select NE, or x values incremented in the case if I select E. So accordingly these values get changed, and whenever they keep on changing, so the same values are used in this right pixel. So after the right pixel, you are closing the while loop. So when you have closed the while loop, so then the last one is the functions flower bracket, so closing the function. So by this we conclude with this midpoint line drawing algorithm, that go through all these parts and see how the derivation is done, and then you will understand how the algorithm is written, and using this algorithm try to write the program with the particular programming language. Thank you.